Micronesian Seminar brings you Island Topics.
Small island societies into the modern world, we see the old values changing. We are seeing the traditional structures of the extended family and the clan system breaking down. And we are seeing the support systems that once existed for the individual breaking down along with them. Hello, I'm Joshua Phillip. I work for the Evism National Government Department of Health Services, Program for Substance Abuse and Mental Health. In this program of Island Topics, we want to look at the subject of how we deal with our anger. So we invite you now to join us as we explore the path that leads from our past to our future.
I don't think we are able to handle anger very well. Okay, we do a lot of denying the anger. Don't get angry. It's bad to get angry.
I wonder how many Micronesians are boiling inside because they are not allowed to express their anger.
Me, when I get angry, I go by vodka, then drink, so it can solve my problem.
They tend not to talk it out, and it just builds up inside of them that they just end up committing suicide. It's more like a time bomb.
For the women, they just actually just regressed. They would not say anything. They just turn into themselves and they won't do anything.
People long time ago, they never expressed their anger in action. They never did. So if they are really get very, very angry, they rather die, but they never speak.
I think it's just worthless, you know, to commit suicide in the first place. I was drunk at the time I did that. And,
Mash.
A long, long time ago, a man named Sato Kawai lived in Nandewas.
Before I proceed, I'd like to apologize to everybody present here, family and all, if what I'm going to say will offend anybody. I would like to apologize for that. My name is Herder, last name Daniel. I'm from Kichi.
One day he caught a very big tuna and he took it home. He decided that he and his family would go ahead and eat the fish. They would not take the fish to the Saudalur, as was customary at the time.
I
was drunk.
I bought incense wood pie.
My wife got mad at me and told me if I drink,
I'll
drink.
When the Saud Alur found this out, he was so mad at him that he decided to put him to death.
That day I was drunk. And somebody told me that my wife and Arandi stayed drinking.
4 days and nights, Saud Kawai was held prisoner, unable to go to sleep or to lie down. Then the Saud Alur decided not to kill him, but to give him a very difficult task to do. He told him that there is a certain fish that lives deep in the ocean. The scale of this fish is so bright that it gives light. So he told Saud Kawai to bring him the scale of this fish. So after gathering different kinds of medicine from all around Pompeii, Saud Kawai left to do his task.
So when I went up and waited for my wife for a long time, she never showed up. At about 7 o'clock, they arrived. They came, and I saw my wife's face. I thought that she was drunk.
He got the scale. And when he returned, the Saud was very happy. Then Saud Kawai returned to his clan on the island where he lived, Pilapalap. They lived in a big house.
So I went out of the house and left. I went for a distance to the place of a breadfruit tree. She came running after me. When she came to me, we had an argument, and I slapped her. In the meantime, her father and mother came and told us to stop and go back and drink the coffee.
He was so mad and discouraged that he told his clan, "We are no longer worthy to be alive." This was due to the difficult task given him by the Saud Alur. It would have made him die.
I went back down to the house where we lived, destroyed our mattress and our clothes, and I burned up two marimars. That's at the house.
And so it happened. Saud Kawai burned the house, and he gathered all his family and threw them into the fire, and all the fire. And afterward, he jumped into the fire and died with all his clan.
I burned the house, and one guy died in the house.
This is the end of the story that reflects anger when it dwelled in the customary lives of Pompeians a long time ago.
I don't mean to do it, but I get drunk. That's what happened.
Get angry when you're drinking? You're crazy. Because of it, my friends, we drink a lot. Anything goes wrong, I say, hey, we advise each other. We're all married, we got kids. Why go to jail and your kids and wife are the
home? Kashai, people generally deal with their anger by either getting drunk or fighting. If they're really angry, they might end up beating up the wife or the kids.
You know, I have so much anger. So when I got drunk, and that's the time this everything explodes, really going out freely.
My patients, we think that if we're drunk, that's the best time to express our inner feelings.
Men expressing anger through time, and when they get intoxicated, that barrier breaks down and things come flying.
We usually get calls regarding drunks, like statistically speaking, an average of 5 or 6 calls per week.
One night I went to Colonia for a drink and have a good time. And
they provoke other people and they get into fights and ended up having us respond to that.
Guys tried to bite me. The jump guy bite me when I ride on my motorcycle.
You're in the rain, no problem.
So I tried to cut the knife from them. And then I cut the knife and tried to stop them. And two of them I stabbed with the knife.
By drinking or consuming alcohol, that also relieves the anger, but for a temporary time, I would say, doesn't cure it.
I really regret what I done. I want to change. People change.
There's power out there in the universe that needs to be tapped. Menkoff scheme.
They go down to the local bar, booze it up, get drunker than a skunk, and they'll let off their steam that way. But women can't do that.
Generally, women, I think, have a lot more difficulty expressing anger. They're not allowed to express openly how mad they are, especially to their husband or brothers.
I cannot tell my parents that I am mad at them.
They take a very traditional way of expressing themselves, namely possession, trance, and use that as the legitimate means. In other words, the males use bottled spirits, and the females use real spirits.
What's my mother's sister? He married to a man, and his father was Thai, his father-in-law. I was observing and looking at her when the spirit come inside her. First he make a very sharp and peak sound, and then she stays still for a while, and then started to talk about what the father-in-law was angering about.
Yeah, it's like shumau.
Pompeians consider this is like a sickness. It usually expresses itself when there is chaos in the family.
Sometimes the spirit gets angry because there are some action that the family is doing which is not right to him. That's what make him angry, and he come and get inside one of the family, and he talk about what was the things that he was angering about.
Most of the work of the spirit is giving advice to the family. The family wants to have peace and harmony.
And what they do is they bring a cow, and that's what settles the matter.
I can tell a ghost to go away from here. I tell him, I'll take care of the problem in the family. Go back. Don't be upset. And he will go.
The traditional way of not expressing your anger, it has some good ways and also bad ways. Like we are able to demonstrate that we respect people, but however, if you do not get rid of those and store them inside you, you know, it's detrimental for your health.
It's going to be frustrated, and suppressing those feelings is probably, you know, it's probably one of their way of hiding their angers. And they're, you know, subconsciously coming out, that's making them feeling, having psychosomatic illnesses.
Keeping it inside myself, it hurt. And I mean, it's stressful, you know, and sometimes I have headaches or, you know, pain that is related to this anger or these problems that I keep in myself. So
they come in actually believing that they may have strained a muscle, pulled something, trying to think of something that they've done that caused them the pain. But, you know, you go a little bit further into their history taking, and this is started saying yes to sleep problems, yes, something going on at home, and you press on the, we call trigger points. Often you treat for depression and the problems go away.
I have one cousin on the island, on the other island. He has many scars on his hands, and he said that he cannot talk to the wife about their problems. So he just, you know, cut himself.
Yeah, see this?
What happened there?
I get angry, get mad at my wife, then I take a knife, pocket knife, then cut it.
The reason why they, you know, hurt themselves is that if they really respect that person, that's why, even though they're really mad, but they cannot even do something to him or her. So instead of expressing themselves to that person, they just want to hurt themselves so people will know that that's how they really, that's how hurt they are.
It was 4 years ago that this happened. I had problems that I wanted to conquer by talking to my parents about it. They just didn't understand what I was going through, and I didn't know who to look to.
For a family, the mother and the father, when a child is growing up, they always tell their child, don't ever raise your voice to the older members of our family because you're young. You cannot do such a thing. That's a disrespect. Because here we really do value respecting older people than the members of your family.
So I end up drinking. And I guess I was drunk.
I have a brother that, you know, on Christmas Day 2 years ago, he hung himself.
I don't think that's the right way to elaborate your problems during while you're drunk.
Because he was drunk, my father did not want to talk to him and said, you can come another time so we can talk.
Because nobody will listen to you because you're drunk.
So he take that as a rejection and just walk out and hung himself.
And the only thing that I could think of was to commit suicide.
What, committing suicide is not good for dealing with anger. How can you solve a problem when you already died?
And so I apparently did that and was found by some of my neighbors.
It hurts. It hurts to see that that happened to me or to my family. But bottom line is, because of anger, because of, you know, despair, that thing happened.
I actually lost a few seconds of my life because I was already hanging. Next thing I knew, I was looking at them lying on the ground.
I think it is better to discuss the anger among them, to settle it, to tell them what he is angry about, so they discuss about it and find a way to settle it.
Now what I do is just try not to ignore the whole problem.
I have to talk. I have to get rid of it. So
that would really help, you know, to have somebody listen to you.
I really do believe in family, you know, and I think the extended family has done a very effective job in controlling anger, and also if they realize that they're gonna talk directly with their parents or somebody, you know, up there that they're gonna talk, they go to the extended family, whether an uncle or an auntie.
Well, there's one time like I got angry at my mom. We have some like personal problems and I cannot talk to her about the problems I have. So I have to talk to one of my aunties.
Usually I don't express it to the people that I'm angry about. But when I go home, I try to talk to my wife and talk it over, and usually it mellows down. A lot of times I get good advice from her by talking to her about my angers.
I think it's better not to keep it inside. Let it go and...
Baby! Give it up! Turn it loose!
Sometimes I would go run and didn't realize that I ran for about 8-9 miles without being tired, just to get stressed out.
Holding on, ain't no use.